Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we are in Computex 2024 here in Taipei in the amazing and lovely Asus booth. With me, we have Sasha. Hey, Sasha.
Good to see you, Alejandro.
Good to see you, man. I see you have some amazing laptops and I can just wait to dive in, so let's start.
Yeah, and we have stuff here. So this one you guys remember, I showed it to you at CES. This one came out half a year ago. Huge success. It's selling three times more than we originally anticipated. So it looks like a regular ultra portable laptop, but then Shazam, you have a second screen right under there and the keyboard automatically switches to Bluetooth mode as soon as you remove it. And then it still works on battery, right? And as soon as you put it back with the pogo pins, it charges and it works just like a regular built-in keyboard, zero latency, never runs out of battery.
Yeah.
Perfect productivity device for on the go. Always have a second screen, has a built-in kickstand, really powerful meter lake, ultra portable for productivity on the go. And then I got two new devices here that we don't have on the booth. So this is just exclusive for you guys. There's some people peeping here through the windows to want to see the devices as well, since we don't display them. These are based on your upcoming Intel Lunar Lake chips. So very excited for that.
Yeah, so I see you have here that this is the Asus ExpertBook.
P5, correct. That's ExpertBook P5. So ExpertBook is our commercial laptops for businesses. And the P5 is going to be a new series. It's kind of like a hybrid series between for businesses and also for regular people like you and me. So there's a lot of people who want really long warranty. So you can get 3 to 5 years of warranty on these.
Oh, nice.
You can buy it like a regular customer, just as your normal at your normal e-tailer or retailer. You get 3 to 5 years. You get 24/7 customer support, VIP customer support, chat or phone call. You have next day on-site repair as well, depending on the country you buy it in. And it's 3-year global warranty. So if you're traveling a lot, you really depend on your laptop. It has to always work, which I'm sure a lot of people can relate to, and especially you guys.
Yeah.
Like if your laptop stops working suddenly, so you have somebody on site within 24 hours who can help you fix it.
This
so,
is great.
Yeah, it's a end user, kind of professional prosumer laptop with amazing warranty and special customer support.
No, I love it. And it's, I think I like love the build. So it's actually really thin and how clean. What type of chassis you guys use for this?
Yeah, so it's an aluminum chassis, 1.4 kilos, 14 inch, and it has two SSDs, really cool as well. A full size 2280 and then a small 2230. So the idea there is that on the 2230, you can have your operating system, your base install, and then you have a full size SSD slot for plenty of storage you can slot in there. Yeah, really interesting device for anybody who wants something super durable, dependable. This has been extensively military grade tested as well.
It's great. It has two Thunderbolt ports, two Type A USB ports, your HDMI out, and my friend audio jack. No, this is solid. Yeah. Really like it.
Yeah, all the ports you need. And then this one, this is my favorite. Really excited about this one. So ZenBook S14. You can see how thin and light it is.
Wow, this is even lighter, and yeah, it's super thin. And actually, that's kind of one of the things that we are. One of the goals for the Lunar Lake architecture to provide this type of thin and light top-end computers, laptops.
Yeah, and you can see pretty much the HDMI port kind of tells you, for everybody at home watching this, as a reference, how thin it is. It barely fits a full-size HDMI port in there. And yeah, it's 1.1 centimeters thin, so super thin, and it only weighs 1.2 kilos. CNC aluminum chassis, very cool grille design up here. Huge glass touchpad, 3K 120 hertz OLED display, same as on the Duo, just a single display, but that's how it gets so light and so thin. And yeah, based on Lunar Lake, 70 watt hour battery in this, I think 72, 73 watt hour battery in this. So combine that with Lunar Lake, with the on-chip memory and all that stuff, you get amazing battery life out of this one.
I can see why this one's your favorite. I can't wait to play with it. It's gonna be amazing.
And for all the ZenBook S models, price is really attractive as well. It's gonna be really interestingly priced. And we got this ceraluminum finish on here. I love this like glossy A monogram we've cut in here. And then the ceraluminum, you can touch it.
Oh wow,
it's super like smooth, ceramic aluminum finish, ceraluminum. No smudges, no fingerprints. You can try it, like eat the most greasy pizza you can find. You won't be able to get any smudges or fingerprints on here. Amazing surface, very grippy, very durable and scratch resistant. Yeah, big fan of the finish.
That was great. I loved it. And then especially I can relate to the greasy surfaces because a lot of my laptops have like my smudge finger in it. But this is so nice. This is really, especially like you said, for us that we travel a lot, this, our backers are definitely gonna say thank to us.
Yeah. And so, pricing wise, this should not be too far over $1,000. So gonna be very interesting.
Well, Sasha, this has been amazing. Is there anything else that we want to see that we should see while we're here?
Yeah, so we also got a really cool new NUC here based on Lunar Canyon, which I'm sure you guys are going to be excited about as well.
Yeah, I can't wait to see it. So yeah, let's go check it out. All right, so now with us, we have Masa. Hi, Masa, how's it going?
Hi, how are you?
Doing well, great, and thanks for having us. So I see we have here two NUCs.
Yes,
We're going to be talking about this. I'm very excited because I think there are two different ones. One looks like it's performance and the other one is something new. So tell us a little bit more about that one.
Okay, let me start with a new one then. So this new NUC is based on the Lunar Lake architecture, right? That just announced by Intel. And we're leveraging that to create a new NUC category with a very high AI performance. We're expecting AI performance tops of over 100 as expected.
Yeah.
So we have put it into our small form factor, and this is going to be one of our lead AI product, right, coming up in, we'll be announcing, launching in Q4 timeframe.
Okay, it's Q4 time. So this has a Lunar Lake architecture and it's, you know, targeted towards all the different AI workloads that are going to come in and that are actually today out in the market. Yeah. And it has the GPU, which you mentioned, and it has a, the top cell for the NPU is around 48 tops.
Yep.
And we also have the GPU and CPU that provides more tops for any different types of AI workloads. I love it when you guys got here. So it has a Type A USB ports, Type C. It also has the Copilot button. So if you need, there we go, AI, your audio jack. And also has, oh wow, it has 2.5 gigabytes Ethernet port.
That's right.
And HDMI out, more Thunderbolt. It's you know, it's a mean little NUC. It's pretty cool. I like it. All right. So what is this guy over here? Tell us more about it.
So, okay. So this is a NUC 14 performance. Mm-hmm. We just announced this last month, getting into Computex timeframe, right? This is our highest performance platform we have today. It is featuring Intel's Core Ultra 9 and Ultra 7 architecture, right? Along with a NVIDIA's RTX 4070 and 4060 graphics. So you have a pretty high-end configuration, right? And like all our NUCs, this is targeted toward both kind of high-end workstation users, right? Commercial users, education, maybe a STEM program, as well as into more of a commercial application driving multiple displays. Because this will drive up to five displays from one system.
Five displays.
Mm-hmm. We're showing that actually in the demo in the Computex booth itself.
No, this is actually, now that you say all that, it came in really handy because earlier this week here at Computex, we were doing a live stream and we were trying to figure out like what type of system will be great because we were running into some hiccups. But then I was thinking like, what would be a good system to carry all over the world, literally, that actually you can have the performance to do streaming. And this guy seems like a great, great candidate to do that. I mean, it like you said, for all the different displays, all the different AIOs, I see you have a full on SD card here. Yep. This is, I mean, it has a lot of muscle that can help us.
Yeah. Plus, because this is more targeted toward the commercial usage, it made it into a very easy way to configure this as well. So it's the toolless design. You can open up right away, right? And then you can actually get the memory. You have one, two, three NVMe SSD slots.
This is great, and it's so easy. Like you just, it's sort of toolless. It opens, easy to, you have two DIMM slots here to upgrade.
And even this is toolless.
Oh wow, quick release on the M.2s for all of them.
All of them.
And I see underneath that M.2, you have the...
This is the Wi-Fi card.
The Wi-Fi card in there. Wow, I really, really like it. And again, so you have here, you can see a little bit of the heatsink, copper. Mm-hmm.
There's three fans running underneath.
Three fans?
Yeah, one for GPU, one for CPU, and one for memory.
Wow.
It's important for us because we want to make sure that we get the maximum performance out of the 2.5 liter package.
Yeah, that's, I mean, it's compact and like you said, for traveling or for, I mean, for all the different usages you mentioned, it's great. I really, really like it.
Okay.
Well, no, Masa, thank you so much. This is great. I love it. Thank you for being here with us.
No, thank you. Thanks for inviting me.
All right. So right now we are at the ROG booth. Before we're in the Asus booth, having a conversation with all our friends over there, with Masa and Sasha. And right now we're actually with Kyle. Hi, Kyle.
Hi. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too. All right. So I see this amazing and brand new motherboard. Tell us more about it.
Yeah. Welcome to the ROG booth. And this is actually the next generation ROG Maximus Hero BTF. And this is a prototype that we brought to the Computex for a sneak peek. And this motherboard features a hidden connector design, as you can see here, and also a high power slot that can deliver up to 600 watts to your BTF graphic cards. And also it has Intel Wi-Fi 7 and plenty of PCIe Gen 5 slots, and also robust cooling for your unmatched performance. And in addition to that, we also have a Q-Release Slim here. That's an advanced version of the original Q-Release. So that's for a quicker installation. And of course, this is ready for the Intel next-gen processors.
Right, so I can see that the release here, you have completely redesigned it, because first you had the quick release with the button,
yes.
And now it's gone. And you were telling me earlier that you can just like slightly twist it and it will come out.
Yeah, exactly. So no buttons, you just pull up your PCI devices.
That's...
And for the BTF ecosystem, BTF stands for Back to the Future. And our ecosystem of motherboards and PCI graphic cards, and also the PC cases, are just in a new era of PC building. And for that, you can see for the hidden connector design and all those PC BTF components, actually, you get a really clear look for the inside of your PC build.
Nice. So,
yes.
It makes a very beautiful, clean build on the front and BTF, so Back to the Future. And by Back to the Future, we go like the back of the motherboard, and this is the future of where things are going to go. And as you can see, all the connectors are in back there and it looks amazing. And also, that's kind of the other reason, you can correct me if I'm wrong, of why you have this high power for the PCIe cards,
yes.
So you don't have the extra ports coming out here,
exactly.
But just provide it right there.
Yes, and we also have partnership with a variety of chassis manufacturers, including AeroCool, Be Quiet, Cooler Master, Corsair, Ingwing, Liam Lee, Silvertech, Silverstone, Femtech, and Thermaltech, etc. So that gives you plenty of options to choose from for your PC build.
Yeah, that's great, because when these motherboards first came, that was one of the main questions people have. Like, okay, I love the concept of having the connectors on the back for a cleaner build, but which cases are going to support? And you guys have already solved that problem. Another thing that I kind of wanted to cover was all the different ports, actually the I/O ports that you guys have here. And as we can see, there's a lot of them. So here we have the Type-A USB, and we are in Type-A. And we have all these different types of ports, and we have the USB-Cs, we have your Ethernet port, you also have these that you don't see anymore. These are like for audio, for different channels. We have your BIOS refresh, which is like a one button refresh, which is pretty easy. These are a quick release for...
Yes, we have a Q antenna. That's for a quicker installation for your Wi-Fi antenna.
And also you have your CMOS clear, which is great. So we have all these great I/O ports. And one of the best things for us who are a little bit older, the I/O shield is already included in there. So
yes.
You don't forget when you're building your system.
Exactly. So that concludes the quick look of this prototype, this next generation ROG Maximus Hero BTF. And I hope you are as excited as we are about the new future of the gaming experiences.
Yes, we're very excited, Kyle. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
Okay, and right now we're with Melody, and we're gonna be talking about this amazing router that just launched, and it's Wi-Fi 7. And Melody, how you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Tell us, so what do we have? This, it's huge, it's awesome,
yeah.
I love it, the red with the black.
So this is our AI network, Asus ROG Rapture GT-BE19000. And it's tri-band performance Wi-Fi 7 gaming router, and with speeds up to 90 Gbps and automatic frequency coordination for optimized Wi-Fi performance. So meanwhile, when it comes to AI network, it means that this all total wired capacity is up to 31G. It's very compatible for like gaming experience for everyone. So right now we have like a light table showing the multi-link operation with Intel B200.
Nice, nice. So you were saying that tri-band is for three different brands of communication?
Yes, 2.4 and 5 and 6 gigahertz band.
Great. And is this already in the market that we can get?
Not yet. It's about the end of July, like first in North America.
And no, this is nice. And what about the ports, the capabilities in the background?
Yes, they are 210G port, quad 2.5G ports, and 1 1G Ethernet port. So okay. Total is 31G IO capacity.
No, this is great. Thank you so much. This has been great.
Thank you.